protecting 30% of the planet would cost less than what the world spends today on video games. My job was to study the impacts of humans, the impacts of fishing and global warming in the ocean, and write about it in scientific journals. But one day I realized that all I was doing was writing the obituary of the ocean. So I felt like the doctor who's telling you how you're going to die with excruciating detail, but not offering a cure. And that day I decided to quit academia to work on the cure. Places that I loved so much were becoming less and less alive every year because of too much fishing and pollution and global warming. Coral reefs were bleaching and dying. There were less and less large fish. Most places didn't have any sharks. But then when I dived in a marine reserve, an area that was fully protected from fishing in the Mediterranean Sea where I grew up, oh my God, I saw everything was there. Everything was back. And that for me was a realization. That first dive in a marine reserve was like, wow, the ocean used to be like this. The seafloor, all the sediment on the bottom of the ocean, is the largest carbon storehouse on the planet. The ocean absorbs so much of our carbon pollution. But our activities are degrading ocean life, are depleting the ocean, and are diminishing the ability of the ocean to capture all of our excess carbon. The ocean is the epitome of out of sight, out of mind. We know much more about the land. We have more detailed maps of the surface of the moon or Mars than of the bottom of the ocean. But we do know that the ocean is absolutely essential for our survival. So we have a huge job, a huge task to educate everybody on the planet that the ocean is absolutely essential for our survival. We produce enough food right now to feed 10 billion people. Only we waste a third of it. So if we fix that, we wouldn't need to explode more fishing grounds or cut more forests or turn grasslands into grazing ranges, right? But also, we know that if we protect more of our planet, the economy will do better. People are going to be able to get more food and be healthier. We'll reduce the costs of healthcare, the cost of climate and nature disasters. When we invest in nature, nature gives back. You know, for example, every dollar that we invest in protected areas produces $10 in return that benefits local communities. So a more protected world, a world with more nature, is a richer, healthier, and wealthier world.